Welcome to your own channel of Ride Funda. Here is a very interesting problem where a body is moving in a viscous force under the action of a special force. So this is a type of problem, challenging problem, and we can say this type of problem appear in usually Olympiad type of exam. So here will be learning a new method of solving problem. Let's read what the question is talking about. A spherical ball of mass m is equal to 1 kg and radius 1 cm is projected from the origin with an initial velocity v0 is equal to 6 root 2 meter per second in I cap direction. In a viscous fluid having coefficient of viscosity eta is equal to 10.6 newton second per meter square as shown in the figure. The space is gravity free, but the ball is always being acted by a force F vector is equal to A vector cross V vector, where A is a constant vector given by A is equal to 2 kg per second in k cap direction, and V vector is the instantaneous velocity vector of the ball. Find the displacement of the ball until the ball stops. So till the time it stops, how much will be the displacement of the ball will be there. This is the diagram has been given to us. Here there is a viscous fluid there, and in this viscous fluid this ball is being released, is given some velocity to this. So this body there, it is going like this. There are two forces will be acting. One is a viscous force, another is a special force F is equal to A cross V. These two forces are acting on this body, and it will be moving in two dimensions. And when it will be stopping, suppose it is stopping here somewhere, then what is the displacement of the ball till that instant, that we need to calculate. Now as you have understood the problem, now you pause the video, think of the problem and try to solve the problem. Take some time. After that again you will be resuming the video, and I will be here is a very interesting problem where a body is moving in a viscous force under the action of a special force. So this is a type of problem, challenging problem, and we can say this type of problem appear in usually Olympiad type of exam. So here we'll be learning a new method of solving problem. Let's read what the question is talking about. A spherical ball of mass m is equal to 1 kg and radius 1 cm is projected from the origin with an initial velocity v0 is equal to 6 root 2 meter per second in I cap direction. In a viscous fluid having coefficient of viscosity eta is equal to 10.6 newton second per meter square as shown in the figure. The space is gravity free, but the ball is always being acted by a force F vector is equal to A vector cross V vector, where A is a constant vector given by A is equal to 2 kg per second in k cap direction, and V vector is the instantaneous velocity vector of the ball. Find the displacement of the ball until the ball stops. So till the time it stops, how much will be the displacement of the ball will be there. This is the diagram has been given to us. Here there is a viscous fluid there, and in this viscous fluid this ball is being released, is given some velocity to this. So this body there, it is going like this. There are two forces will be acting. One is a viscous force, another is a special force F is equal to A cross V. These two forces are acting on this body, and it will be moving in two dimensions. And when it will be stopping, suppose it is stopping here somewhere, then what is the displacement of the ball till that instant, that we need to calculate. So how to solve this problem? If you draw the free body diagram of the ball, suppose if the ball is there, then it will be two forces will be acting. One is the viscous force that will be given by Stokes' law, and the viscous force, we know that V is equal to 6 pi eta r V, and it acts in the direction of the opposite to the velocity with respect to the fluid medium. So it is the minus 6 pi eta r V. So for the timing, let's keep this as the minus k V. Take this, where k is equal to 6 pi eta r V. this is one force that will be acting, and another force that is given, that the F1 suppose, that is given as A vector cross V vector. A vector cross B vector. These two forces that will be acting on the ball, but representing it will be difficult there. Suppose it is going in the V direction, it is going right now. So it will be one force will be like this, that is the F force at that instant. And this our A vector is going in the kcap direction. So kcap cross B vector, kcap cross B vector. Suppose I take this as the X axis, as given the question, there's a Y axis, then upward will be K axis. And A K vector cross this V vector will be like this, perpendicular to this. So these two forces will be acting on this body. So one of the method can be to solve this problem, that resolve all the forces in a different direction, different mutually perpendicular direction, and solve the equation of motion. But today I'll be explaining another method of solving this problem. Let's solve this problem by vector method directly. So what I can write, this F net, net force acting on the system, I can write the F1 vector plus this F vector. So this can be written as, this is equal to A vector, constant vector A, we don't know where is it, the kcap direction is given, constant vector, and minus k v vector. And this I can write is equal to m into a, or mass into dv by dt. I can write mass into dv by dt. This what I can write, a cross, this is the rate of change of position vector dr by dt minus k dr by dt. So I can cancel dt 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 all the three sides, and we can write m dv is equal to a cross dr vector minus k dr vector. So now if I integrate both the sides of the equations, I will integrate like this side. At initially position vector was 0, where it is the origin, and at that time the velocity is given the v naught I cap, and sub at m t the velocity is v that I want to find out, and position vector equal to r. But in this question it is given that final velocity is given at the 0 when it is stopping. Velocity is stopping at the time I am going to calculate. So the left hand side will be equal to m v naught minus I cap is equal to a is a constant vector gone out of the differentiation, and is equal to delta r vector. So what are the final vector, the delta r, or final position vector, minus k delta r. So we don't know this, whatever delta r will be there, we don't know. But one thing is sure from this, that the directions of this vector minus this vector has to be equal to minus I cap direction. That is for sure. So delta r vector not known to us, but we can calculate delta r vector. But how to do? How to proceed from this step right now? You see that one thing we can see, these two vectors, they are perpendicular to each other, because that in the direction of delta r, this second quantity, and this is a cross delta r, means this is perpendicular delta. So these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. So if I want to, because question is asking about finding out the magnitude of the displacement vector, delta r ka magnitude to find out. So without losing the generality, I can remove the vector signs to obtain the answer. So if I take the magnitude of both the sides, what I need to do is that I can put this one, mod of this is equal to mod mv naught, that I am to calculate this vector, is equal to this delta r taken outside. What is the magnitude? Because these two vectors are perpendicular to each other, so the magnitude of the resultant vector is nothing but a square plus k square. So I got the equation, the delta r, of course not the sign, so delta r magnitude can be calculated to be equal to m v naught by square root of a square plus k square. Now if we put the values of those quantities, mass is given to us, initial velocity is given to us, a magnitude is given to us, k magnitude is 6 pi eta r b, 6 pi eta r, that is k we have taken, we will substitute these values here, then we will be obtaining the answer. If we refer the question, then what are the data are given to us is that the radius of the ball is given at the 1 centimeter. The initial speed is given at the 6 root 2 meter per second. The coefficient of viscosity is given 10.6 Newton. And the constant is given the 2 kg per second in the k cap direction. So these are the values if you take and substitute in our equations, and mass is also given at the 1 kg. So these are the values we'll substitute, we'll get the answers very easily. If you want to calculate 6 pi eta rv, if you put the values of this 6 into 22 by 7 into 10.6 into 1 by 100, that is equal to 1 centimeter, then this value is roughly, this will come out to be equal to 2, 1.9 around will come. These are two values there. And the A value, this is equal to K value is this, and A value is equal to 2. So from this we can get under root of A square plus K square is equal to 2 root 2. So if I to put these values to be equal to 2 root 2, and M is 1 kg and speed is going to 6 root 2. So this, I can calculate these values to be equal to delta R magnitude comes out to be equal to 6 root 2 in the numerator by 2 root 2 in the denominator. So this will come out to go 3 meter in the magnitude of the displacement of the ball which is moving in a viscous fluid, and another force of A cross R is acting. So let's see what we discuss, what are things we did. If we try to recall the strategy what you adopted is that we took this value vectorically, you write all the forces we have written, and here is a V, here A is there. What we want to find out, that we know the limit of the velocity is known to us, so we are at dr by dt, dt to be cancelled, and we have taken this A cross delta R and A delta R things came. So as we are interested with delta R there, we took the magnitude of this one. So these two vectors are perpendicular to each other were there. So we took the magnitude at the delta R mod into under root of A square plus K square, and these are momentum's magnitude will be there. And from that we calculated delta R value to be equal to 3 meter.